Hello dear students, how are you? I hope you will be fine. I am also fine. Once again, I welcome you on my channel. Okay students, as you know that I have started math of 9th class. So I have started exercise 2.4. In the last video, we had done question number 1 in which we had done simplification by using the laws of exponents. So the same exercise, and we'll do question number 3, simplify, and it's the second part. Most of the students have very difficulty in solving this part of the question. So students, let's start. First of all, we have to watch carefully these numbers inside the brackets. We have to check their exponents. The exponent of this number is 2 by 3 and exponent of 25 is 1 over 2. I told you exponent means power of a number. So the exponent of this number 0.4 is minus 1 over 2. According to the exponents, we have to write these numbers in factors. So 216. First of all, we'll check that can we factorize this number 216 into 3 parts, because in the exponent we have 2 by 3. It is as a denominator, so we can cancel the power of a number which will have power 3. So we'll check. If we multiply 4 3 times, 4 4s are 16, 16 4s are 32, 5 5 5s are 25, 25 1 25, 6, we'll multiply them 3 times, 6 6 are 36, and 36, let's see, 6 6 are 36, 6 3s are 18, and plus 3 is 21. So exactly we have got the number. This number we can write in place of this number, because by multiplying 3 times 6 we have got this number. So we can write power of 6. 3 will be the power of 6, and the whole exponent will be written same. Now 25 is a simple number, students, so we know that we can write it 5 power 2. Whole power or exponent is 1 by 2. In the next step, we have to remove this decimal. When we remove this decimal, we'll get 4 in the numerator, because there are 2 numbers after the decimal. So students will get 100 in the denominator, and its whole exponent, or its exponent, is minus 1 over 2. So this is our first step. Let's see what we'll do in the next step. Students, you have to watch it and understand it very carefully. Now the exponent of 6 is 3. 3 will be sent out of the bracket, and it will be multiplied by the whole exponent, which is 2 by 3. Let's do it. In the next step, we'll write this radical sign again, and 6 will remain in the bracket, but its exponent 3 will be multiplied by the whole exponent. Same case here with 5 exponent 2. will multiply this exponent 2 with the whole exponent 1 over 2. And something different will do in the whole denominator. Here you can see this is 4 and this is 100. So according to its exponent, we have 2 in the denominator. So you can see here 2 2's are 4 and 10 10's are 100. We can write 4 as 2 power 2. We can write 100 as 10 power 2. And its whole exponent is minus 1 over 2. So let's do next step. Now check, these numbers are same in the numerator and denominator. Powers will be cancelled. And this will remain same. So in the numerator we'll get 6 power 2 into 5 power 1 is left. And check, both 2 and 10 students have the same power, square. So we can combine the powers of these two numbers and they can be written outside the bracket. 2 will be combined and be written on the outside of the bracket, and it will be multiplied by minus 1 over 2. And in the next step, the numerators will be written same. You will write the power of 5, 1. And in the next step, we can see the powers will be cancelled. 2 and 2 are in the numerator and in the denominator, so they will be cancelled. And you can cut these two numbers because they both are cancelled by the same number. 2, 2 ones are 2 and 2 fives are 10. So we are left with in the denominator 1 over 5 and power or exponent minus 1. So let's see in the next step. The numerator terms will remain same. 6 square and 5 power 1. And look at this. Students, we have a negative or exponent with minus. When we turn 1 by 5, this fraction upside down, this negative sign will turn into positive sign. So it will become 5 by 1 and minus power will turn into positive. It will remain 1. So students, to do next step, we have to erase on the left hand side. In the next step, students, because you know that one, if you don't write 1 in the denominator, so it will be okay. It will remain only 5. 6 power 2, 5 power 1 will remain same. And we can write 5 over 1 as only 5 power 1. So now it has become a bit easy now. We'll take this denominator with power 1 or exponent 1 in the numerator. When we shift a denominator into numerator or a numerator into denominator, its exponent's sign will be changed. So students, 6 power 2 multiplied by 5 power 1 will remain same. This denominator will be shifted in the numerator, so its exponent will get minus in the its exponent will get minus power. So now you can see 6 power 2 will remain same, and number 5 is same, so their powers will be added. It will become 1 minus 1. Now students, again 6 will remain, 6 power 2 will remain same, but these two, 1 minus 1 will be written, it will become 0. 1 minus 1 is 0, and the number having power 0 is equal to 1. So in the next step, we'll erase these steps on the right hand side of the whiteboard. Okay students, let's see. This number with power 0 will become 1. Any number, whether it is the bigger or the smaller one, if it has 0 power, it will be equal to 1. So 6 power 2 will remain same, and in place of this we will write 1. So we have got 6 power 2 only, and its square will be cancelled by the square root, and we'll get 6 as the answer. So students, this is how to simplify a complex number. I hope that you have understood it very well. Students, if you want to make maths easy for you, quickly subscribe my channel and don't forget to press bell icon and select the option of all, so that you could get all the notifications of my latest videos. Students, that's all for today. We'll meet in the next class. Till then, goodbye. Have a nice day. God bless you all.